Welcome back to the Huddle, Fox Sports 1700. Carlos Roberto along with Jake Berry. And this show brought to you by Christina Sala, State Farm Insurance in McAllen. Miracle Medical. Get your Don Joy brace at Miracle Medical in Weslaco. Wear what the pros and what they wear in college. And McDonald's. I'm loving it. Breakfast from across all day long. And breakfast across the Rio Grande Valley at McDonald's. We got one more score to pass along. La Feria and Coach Salinas, congratulations to them. La Feria wins. They beat Vville Johnson.
60 Jones.
Yeah, that didn't sound right. Beville Jones, 67-31. So the Lions going on to the next round of the playoffs. The newspaper had the game against Weslaco and Weslaco East as a wild one, and I'll put it up right there. A wild one on Thursday night, and talk about starting off the bi-district round of the playoffs in a great game. And I always love it when these valley, the top valley teams, play against each other. You know, next week we're going to have Harlingen and Memorial. To start off this round, we had Weslaco East versus Brownsville Vets, and we have Coach Mike Burget on the line right now to talk to us a little bit about this game. And Coach, what does it feel like? Second year in a row, you guys are moving on to the second round of the playoffs.
First of all, good morning, Carlos and Jake. We're excited. You know, we were to sleep that night after the game. It was a close one. It come down to inches, yards. You know, our defense came up big and stopped them on the two-point conversion, and we're very excited about moving on. The kids are excited. You know, their goal is to win a title. We couldn't get it done in district, but we got a bi-district champion, and now we're going to see if we can go get another area championship.
That's right. You guys are moving on to the next round of the playoffs. It's going to be either Del Rio, who's going to be playing, or La Jolla Palmview, and that game is taking place in Del Rio. So I know you guys are already up in Del Rio, getting ready to scout that game, which is going to be taking place at 2 o'clock. But let's talk a little bit more about that game. We've kind of hashed it out and looked at it a little bit. Your defense actually played very, very well, but it came down to the very, very end. They needed to make one more play towards the end. And like we talked about afterwards on Thursday night, you kind of knew that on they were going to go for it on two. At least, you know, Coach Guzman said, yeah, we knew they were going to go for two after they scored that touchdown. They wanted the win.
Yeah, I mean, Coach Kuzman is a great coach. He runs a great program. They got a bunch of good coaches over there. Their kids are, man, they got a lot of talent. So, you know, we figured they'd want to go for the win, and Coach Kuzman and the defense coaches had them in position to make the stop. And Cito and Choo-Choo and Fonte, both those kids came up and hit the kid, and the ball came loose. And, man, it was a great feeling.
How did all year long, Coach? You played in some big games. You played against, you know, that was a huge game against San Benito. Of course, the game the previous week against Weslaco High School was a huge game. Then you have another big game that you know, Brownsville Vets. How did you get these kids up after, you know, playing in the biggest game of the year the previous week? Then they have to, you know, now they have, okay, no, that wasn't actually the biggest game of the year. This is the biggest game of the year because now, you know, it's in the playoffs. So how did you get your team up for that game?
Well, you know, the one thing is at Weslaco East, you know, playing the Cedar Park and the Steel, you know, we played Cedar Park back-to-back years and Steel last year. So I think our kids know how to play in the big game. You know, unfortunately, you know, we came up a little bit short against a good Weslaco High team. And we threw that last night beating Los Fresnos. You know, our district is very strong. Everybody questioned our district. But, you know, against a district down there that they said was the strongest district in the valley, you know, we end up 2-2. So, you know, the district is very strong. We've got good teams in, year out. And, you know, we come to play. And when you lose, you know, you got to let those games go, you know. It's going into the playoffs. And it was a hard game to let go. I really believe our kids played even with Weslaco. The score didn't show it at the end, but, you know, we hit them and they hit us. So, you know, we had to let that go real quick and turn around and play a very different, explosive a team that led their district in scoring. You know, they averaged 40 points a game, and our defensive coaches, you know,
turned out to be all right. No, there was never a doubt what we were going to do. We came here to win this football game. We felt like we had a great opportunity to do it right there.
This is how you start off playoff football. Brownsville Vets at Weslaco East for a bi-district championship. First quarter action, and it's the Wildcats. Emilio Tamez with the first big play of the game. This one down the sideline and stopped at the 30-yard line. And Ben Moore, Tamez, Emilio, stretches it out just short to the one-yard line. Two plays later, over the top, he just gets in there. Touchdown, Weslaco East is on top, 7-0. Betts now, a little bit of trickery. Back to the quarterback on the double reverse, and it's picked off. It's Ciro Rojas. He plays running back, also defensive back, with the big interception right here to stop that drive. Later, it's Tamez. His second touchdown of the game. Wildcats with a 14-0 lead at the half. We go to the third quarter now. Both teams make their adjustments, and Carlos Garza finds the end zone to cut into the Wildcat lead, 14-7. Vets back again. And they're passing here, moving down the field till it's picked off. JC Vargas comes up with a big play right here to stop the drive. Give that man some Gatorade. East now, driving here. Ciro Rojas in and out of traffic and knocked out of bounds at the 2-yard line. Tamez finishes the drive in the end zone, and it's 21-7. Weslaco East leading in the fourth quarter. Still plenty of time, though, for Brownsville veterans. And the Chargers don't go away. Marcus Castile running with the football right here. He finds the end zone, 21-14. We got ourselves a game. East has the ball, but they had the punt. And this one would roll and roll and roll inside the 1-yard line, and that's where the Chargers would start their
Daniel Mendez, Matthew Garcia, and Gavin Gaetan. All those guys are big guys, maybe not as big as the teams that we play, but, you know, they execute well. Their technique's great. Coach Trevino and Sergio Martinez does a good job of getting those guys to, you know, move their feet and try to open up the best running lanes possible for the running back. So, you know, my hands off to Coach Trevino and Coach Martinez. You know, they always get guys to next level. We're hoping to get one or two there. He might not be Division I kids, but there's a college out there for them.
Absolutely, Coach. Absolutely, Coach. Now, taking a look, Del Rio's coming up, either Del Rio or Palmview. It looks like Del Rio has the upper hand, or at least the favorite coming into this game. What type of, you know, we know Palmview, either one, whichever one you what kind of offenses do these two teams run real quick?
Well, Palmview likes to run the ball like us. I mean, their majority run. They got a heck of a running back. We're going to watch here in a little bit. He's fast. You know, he's back. He's been banged up. Del Rio runs his spread. You know, they throw the ball a little bit more. They got two small running backs, but they're quick. You know, either team's going to be a challenge. You know, when you get to the second round, even the first round, I mean, let's face it, anytime you get to the playoffs, you're going to face great teams. And, you know, last year, Palmview was the underdog, went to Laredo and upset DJ, I believe, and we had to play them over there. So, you know, either team that plays, we'll be ready. We're excited to play in the second round. If we play Del Rio, we're going to play up in San Antonio on Saturday. I don't know what time yet.
Do you know where, Coach, in San Antonio?
Well, there's four different places, so, okay. You know, I don't – as soon as I know, you know, I'll get back with you guys. But, you know, we're going to talk that out after the game if they win, and hopefully around 2 o'clock. But if we Palmview wins, we play at home there at Weslaco Lackey Stadium. So we're sort of excited about that. You know, I don't want to say I'm pulling for one team, but anytime you can play at home, you know, I'm hoping Palmview can pull the upset. But, you know, if they can't, you know, we'll go to San Antonio and try to bring our A game and try to bring, you know, another area championship back to Weslaco East.
So if Del Rio wins, you're playing 2 p.m. in San Antonio. That's going to be a Saturday game, obviously.
Yes, yes.
Oh, okay, and Palmview game would be a Friday game.
Correct, 7:30 Friday at our place.
Okay, cool.
Drive, they go to work here. Vets, passing. Then it's the Chargers right here. Jeremiah Myers with the big play right here. Tack on an extra 15 yards for a horse collar. And the Chargers are in business. Castile running with a football inside the 25-yard line. Here they are passing to the 5-yard line. 28 seconds left in the game. Castile with the ball here. He finds the end zone, touchdown, 21-20, Weslaco with the lead. And the Chargers don't hesitate at all. They're going for two. Here's the play right here. Quarterback Castillo sets up. Then he moves out, and they run a wildcat. Start running to the left-hand side, then back to the right-hand side. They throw it to Castillo, but the defense is there. Watch Rojas come up and make a big play. Also into the play there is Jesus Infante knocking the ball loose. And the Wildcats win it, stopping the two-point conversion, 21-20.
Yeah, baby!
Were you surprised at all if they went for two, Coach?
No. That guy's a great coach. He's got great players. He trusted them. It was a great call on his part, and if he catches it, he looks like a genius, and we're done. But now that they drop it, we look like maybe a genius, maybe not, but we're going on.
No, we knew they were going to get out to try and go for two, so we told our kids right before we got out there, look, they're going to drive, we got to stop them. If they end up scoring, we got to stop them because they're going to go for two. So we lined up and played the best we could, and turned out to be all right.
No, there was never a doubt what we were going to do. We came here to win this football game. We felt like we had a great opportunity to do it right there.
This is how you start off playoff football. Brownsville Vets at Weslaco East for a bi-district championship. First quarter action, and it's the Wildcats. Emilio Tamez with the first big play of the game. This one down the sideline and stopped at the 30-yard line. Then more, Tamez. Emilio stretches it out just short to the 1-yard line. Two plays later, over the top, he just gets in there. Touchdown, Weslaco East is on top, 7-0. Vets now with a little bit of trickery. Back to the quarterback on the double reverse, and it's picked off. It's Ciro Rojas. He plays running back, also defensive back, with a big interception right here to stop that drive. Later, it's Tamez. His second touchdown of the game. Wildcats with a 14-0 lead at the half. We go to the third quarter now. Both teams make their adjustments, and Carlos Garza finds the end zone to cut into the Wildcat lead, 14-7. Vets back again. And they're passing here, moving down the field till it's picked off. JC Vargas comes up with a big play right here to stop the drive.
Well, thank you very much.
Give that man some Gatorade. East now, driving here. Ciro Rojas in and out of traffic and knocked out of bounds at the 2-yard line. Tamez finishes the drive in the end zone, and it's 21-7. Weslaco East leading in the fourth quarter. Still plenty of time, though, for Brownsville veterans. And the Chargers don't go away. Marcus Castile running with a football right here. He finds the end zone, 21-14. We got ourselves a game. East has the ball, but they had to punt. And this one would roll and roll and roll inside the 1-yard line, and that's where the Chargers would start their drive. They go to work here, Vets. Passing. Then it's the Chargers right here. Jeremiah Myers with the
in the 90s, they retired his number, actually. That's how good he was, because he played at TCU as a tight end. Good friend of mine, so I know the whole backstory. And then, of course, he was in training camp.
Tiny,
with the
tiny
Bears.
Guy.
Yeah, small, 6'5".
Yeah, his hands are like bananas.
Yeah, he'd be tiny if he was in the NBA, because he'd be a 6'5" guard. But we're going to go ahead and take a break right now, and like to thank everybody for listening to the show on Fox Sports 1700. Carlos Robledo, Jake Berry here. Like to thank Christina Salas, State Farm Insurance from McAllen, Miracle Medical, home of the Don Joy Brace in Weslaco, and McDonald's. McDonald's from across the Rio Grande Valley, now serving breakfast all day long, and also the McRib is back. So let's take a break. When we come back, we'll have more football here on The Huddle.